The dame said you would be coming. Your friends are waiting at the chapel atop the hill. Go now.
Any trouble on the way?
None worth mentioning.
As I was telling Jill, it's worse than I thought. The capital's crawling with soldiers.
And here I am, the deserter come home.
Which is why we'll be taking the back door. Cheer up, you two. Can't think of a safer place in the Empire than it. Brothel.
Really? Doesn't seem very private.
So then, how do we proceed?
We'll be using the glass gate. Tonight, just after sunset.
Where the shards are loaded for transport. That is one of the most heavily guarded points in all of Sambrek.
But not the most, which is a start. Besides, I know a shortcut straight to the heart.
A shortcut? And how exactly did you come to know about this fatal chink in the Empire's armor?
Let's just say I may have attempted something similar before. And may have ended up running for dear life after being discovered by the armor, but that's not important.
Cid, if the Mother Crystals truly are the cause of the Blight...
If? You wound me, Jill.
What I'm trying to say is, if the powers that be know all of this, why do they sit idle and allow it to continue?
In case you haven't noticed, the God-fearing people of this realm and their pious leaders care for but one thing, themselves. And they'll do whatever it takes to hold on to power. The rest of us are just a means to an end. The moment you raise your voice against them, you're decried as an outlaw, clapped in irons and slung in a cell to rot.
An outlaw.
Whoever controls the crystals controls the realm. But our kind can wield magic without them. To our rulers, we must seem the most convenient of tools, and the most dangerous.
But what makes them think they have the right to use us? To leave us to die when our bodies are spent?
Does a nobleman weep for a broken mug? A torn tunic? Our fate means nothing to them. No, this isn't a battle you can win with words. Believe me, I've tried, but nothing ever gets through. The world is simply not ready to listen. So to hell with talking. If they won't give us a say, we'll decide our fates another way. You can't blame a man for wanting to bring an end to all this, can you?
I can't. But what of all the people you mean to rob of their comforts? Are you happy for them to call you outlaw?
Sid the Outlaw. Aye, that'll do me.
You might at least pretend to take this seriously.
Have a little faith, Jill. Even if you don't think much of my choice of digs. If it means my deeds will be remembered, I'll gladly play the role of villain. But first, we have a gate to crash. And once we're in, there'll be no turning back. So you best make ready. The world won't save itself.
It seems as though Jill and perhaps even Clive are not completely sold on Sid's assertion that the mining of the crystals is destroying the world. The use of the crystals is destroying the world. He seems to not be terribly separated from the antagonist in terms of his views, but his methods are very different. Sid doesn't seem to want to subjugate the human race, but he does see his people's place in the world.